Government lifted the ban on sugar imports to avert the scarcity allegedly created by traders to exploit the consumers. Prices had by close of last week skyrocketed to 7,000 shillings and selling at 10,000 in some upcountry trading centers. But with the lifting of the ban, there are still fears that with the high cost of flight, handling and transportation, sugar prices are likely to keep high.
It will give you a kilo before you bring it from Dubai or London or anywhere, before putting it in a wagon to ship it down, it will be fetching what we'll be calling for 2,132 Uganda shillings. Now when you move it from wherever you want to move it to Mombasa, Uganda, by the time it reaches here and goes to the shelf, it will be approximately fetching or calling for 3,500 Uganda shillings even then. So whether the ban, the importation is lifted or not, the price will not go or will not go below 3,300 Uganda shillings.
Kampala City traders are inviting government to make similar offers in other sectors that have for long cried for its intervention. Kasita spokesperson Issa Sechito says similar offers on rice and wheat would avert an impending food crisis and cautioned government against abuse of the lift of the ban by selecting a few companies to benefit.
We have certain companies, I might not name them, that have been for over the time importing the sugar, but they got out of it because of the restrictive taxes. Can you think about this? Think about their records, and then we are the ones that we shall guide. Can you think about the warehouses? URA and the Minister of Finance should inspect the capacities of our members before they can give them the letters to do the importation of the sugar.
Local manufacturers are, however, optimistic that the recent announced intervention by government will help retail consumers.
It is the onus of the government to see how best they can empower the local manufacturers to beat the growing demand. That is government side. But if we suffocate them and allow in any other person to bring in, ours will never grow bigger, and which is not good for our economy and the country at large.
Traders have blamed the sugar scarcity on global factors, saying the major producers such as Brazil were affected by floods and are instead using sugar to produce electricity. Other factors such as the suspension of the production by local factories for servicing and low sugarcane production, coupled with industrial action that saw workers burn plantations, are equally to blame. From this business, I'm Nankunga Inskasirie and Priscilla Chisache.